Hello everyone! In this episode, we will learn about the use callback and use memo hooks. As you can see, I already have our application up and running using npm start, so let's get to it. First things first, what is the purpose of those hooks? Let's start with the useMemo hook. This hook allows us to memoize a value based on dependencies. Let's say we have a function inside one of our components that will compute something based on a few arguments. Normally, this function is going to run on every render, but if none of those arguments change, the result will also be the same. So why should it run on every render? This is where the useMemo hook comes in. It returns a memoized value and only recalculates it if one of the useMemo dependencies change. In some cases, this can greatly improve our application performance. I know this may be a bit hard to imagine, so let's start with an example. As always, I'll start by importing the hook. I am at the top of the app.js file, and I'll just add useMemo next to all of our other hooks. So let me just quickly reorganize this, because we have a lot of hooks already, and in here, let's add useMemo, and let's also import useCallback while we're at it. Save, and now let's create a function that we will memoize using the useMemo hook. In this function, I am going to make use of our counter value, and let's say that this function is going to calculate the square root of our counter value. So I'm going to type const counter square root. This is going to equal the useMemo hook. Let's pass in the function and let's also add dependencies. And the only dependency is going to be counter state.counter value. And in here, we are going to calculate the square root. So let's do math.square root and counterState.counter value. Let's also add a console.log inside this function so we know when does it run. So I'm going to type calculate square root. Finally, let's add the square root to our JSX. So in here, or let's say right here, I'm going to create a paragraph, and in here counter square root, and let's also add some text. The square root is save, and there it is. And now if we test it out, we see that it is being calculated correctly. And second, it is only being calculated whenever the counter value changes. So if I, for example, do update property 1, we can see nothing is happening in here. This is because it has a single dependency, the counter value, and this dependency isn't changing. If we didn't use the useMemo hook, it probably wouldn't matter all that much in our case, but if you are doing much more complex calculations, the useMemo hook can really improve your application performance. Now, let's take a look at the useCallback hook. This hook is very similar to the useMemo hook, but instead of memoizing a value, it memoizes a callback. This is particularly useful when you are passing functions to nested components, for example, event handlers. Let's say that you have a pure nested component, and if you pass a function and don't make use of the useCallback hook, the component will always re-render because the function is always different. However, if you make use of the useCallback hook, the component will re-render only if the function really changes, basically whenever the dependencies change. Let's once again create an example. First, I'll create a function that will log the counter value to the screen using useCallback hook like this. So, const log counter value, this is going to equal the useCallback hook. Let's pass in the function. The single dependency is also going to be counter state.counter value. And the content is going to be console.log, log counter value, so we know what is happening, and counter state.counter value. Save, and now in order to demonstrate, I have to create a pure component. So in here, I'll type class pure nested component, and this has to extend the react.pure component because we want it to be pure. So let's do render, return. And in here, let's do heading with the text of pure nested component. Now, let's also render this component above in the app component. So I'll render it right about here. And let's also pass in our newly created function as a prop. So log counter value is going to equal log counter value. Finally, let's call this function from our pure nested component whenever it renders. So right about here, I'll do this dot props dot log counter value, call it, save. And now if I refresh, you can see log counter value 0. And if I update the property 1, nothing is happening. Only if I update the counter value, this function is being called. Which means that only if the counter value changes, the nested pure component is being re-rendered, which is essentially exactly what we wanted. You can check for yourself that if you were to remove this dependency, or rather the full dependency array, the pure component would always re-render because the function would always be different. And that's all for this episode. In the next one, we will learn how we can create our custom hooks that can make our code much more usable and therefore much more powerful. If you have any suggestions or questions, let me know in the comments and I'll answer every single one of them. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to leave a like and subscribe to see more videos like this in the future. Thanks for watching.